everyone. Welcome to Epic Kids Online. I'm Ashley, and I'm so excited to be spending the morning with you. I want to kick off our time together with a question. Have you ever written a thank you note before? Here's a couple of really cool examples. You can buy them at the store, you can make them at home. When I was a kid, my mom made my brothers and I write thank you cards all the time for everything. Gifts, fancy meals, outings, family visits. Sometimes I didn't really feel very into writing thank you cards, but as an adult, I love them. Every time I get one in the mail, it's like getting a hug from someone I care about. And it's really nice to know that my actions and words are appreciated by other people. So this week, I would encourage you to write a thank you note to someone and send it. You never know, you might just make their day with your note in the mail. But you might be thinking, what do thank you notes have to do with the Bible? Well, more than you might think. This week, we're going to study a story about Jesus healing 10 men. And one of the men comes back to Jesus and says, thank you. And Jesus blesses him even more by healing him spiritually. It's a really great reminder that God likes for us to say thank you when he blesses us. But before we get into our story today, let's take some time and sing a worship song together and praise God for how awesome he is.
I run to the Father, fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 oh. I run to the Father, fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, the reason away. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 oh. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 again and again. Oh, oh, oh.
All together, let's sing that one more time.
I run to the Father.
Come on.
Fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again.
Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem when he entered a village. 10 men cried out to him, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." The men did not come close to Jesus because they had a skin disease called leprosy. Jesus saw them and said, "Go and show yourselves to the priest." Jesus wanted the men to follow the law God had given to Moses. The law said, a person who had a skin disease had to go to a priest to be examined when the disease was gone. The priest and the person had to follow certain rules so the person could live a normal life among people again. As they went, the 10 men were miraculously healed. One of the men, seeing that he was healed, went back to Jesus. He praised God and fell face down at Jesus' feet, thanking him over and over. This man was a Samaritan. Jesus asked the man, "Weren't 10 men cleansed? Where are the others?" Only this man, a foreigner, had returned to give thanks and praise to God. Jesus told him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has saved you." Jesus healed the 10 men who cried out to him. The one who had faith was saved. When we trust in Jesus by faith, he heals us from something greater than a disease. He saves us from our sins. We can give him thanks and worship him for making us new.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Kylie from Casper, Wyoming asks,
why does God want our praise? Does he need us to praise him?
That is a great question. Does God need us to praise him? Well, that I would say no, but I would be really hesitant about saying no point blank there. Let me explain a little bit. Does God need us to praise him? No, he needs nothing. He does not need anything from us. He has existed for all of eternity. Even before he created people, he was getting along fine without us. So he doesn't need our praise from that perspective. However, he wants our praise, and he calls on us to praise him for his glory and our good. Remember, everything God does is for those two reasons, for his glory and our good. When we praise God because of how good he is, how beautiful he is, how he has given us things, he's provided for us, when we praise him, we call attention to his glory. And God uses that so that we can let other people around us know how good God is. So our praise can be used as a tool to draw others to him. And so in that sense, he needs us to do this so that we can make him known to the world. But here's the beautiful part. God calls on us to praise him because it's for our good. It puts our hearts in the right place. It lets us live with gratitude, with joy. And God knows that when we praise him, it's for our good. So he calls on us to praise him for that reason as well. It's really a great thing when you stop and think about it. So does God need us to praise him? Not really, but it's a great gift that he's given us to call on us to praise him so that he can be glorified in others around us and so that he can be central in our lives, that we can recognize that he is the most important and he's beautiful and it changes our lives as we live for him. So here's a question back for you. What attribute or quality of God stirs up praise in you?
There was once a little girl with brown eyes. She desperately wanted blue eyes, so she prayed and prayed for God to turn her brown eyes blue. God did not turn her eyes blue. He had bigger plans for this little girl and her brown eyes. The little girl's name was Amy Beatrice Carmichael. She was born in Ireland in 1867. Amy's father died when she was just a teenager. When he died, the family business suffered as well. Even though Amy's family had very little, it didn't stop her from helping others. She delivered food and she shared the gospel with others in need. Amy often went to places like the slums in her city. These weren't very nice places to live. Even though there were bugs, rats, and sickness everywhere, Amy loved the people there and knew they needed to hear about Jesus. Eventually, Amy got really sick and had to live with family and friends. During this time, she heard a famous missionary speak about the need for people around the world to hear the gospel. Amy realized God was asking her to be a missionary. In 1884, Amy left for India. She worked hard to learn the language and the culture. To better fit in, she learned to eat and prepare Indian dishes, and she also wore traditional Indian clothes. Because Amy did not have blue eyes, her brown eyes also helped her to be accepted by those around her. Amy soon realized there were many young girls and women who needed help in India. They were living on the streets or in unclean places like the slums back in her hometown. Amy provided a safe place for hundreds of these girls and women. She cared and loved for them. Many learned about the love of God for the very first time. Amy Carmichael loved and served the people of India for 55 years. She became Amma, the Indian word for mother, to many people there, and many others chose to follow Jesus through her work and testimony.
What a great story today, and we also had such a cool bonus story. We learned about Amy Carmichael, who is a missionary to India. I'm sure she got to wear some beautiful garments like this scarf, this lovely necklace, and also these earrings when she had a special occasion. Amy was called by God to go to India and serve people who needed spiritual and physical healing, just like Jesus did for the people in our Bible story today. She chose to live in the poorest neighborhood so she could be closer to the people she wanted to serve. And she sacrificed her own personal comfort to better share the gospel with others. What an inspiration. She's such an awesome lady. Now, after our stories this week, you may have some questions. I would encourage you to spend some time talking through those with your parents. Two questions I had were, what should we do when good things happen to us? And what should we do when bad things happen to us? As we close our time together, let's pray. Dear God, we confess that we don't always praise you and give thanks for all the blessings that you give us in our life. We pray that you would change our hearts and help us to show more gratitude to you and to other people who do right by us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thanks so much for spending the morning with us. We have one more worship song before we wrap up, but that's all for me. I hope you have a great week, and we'll see you next time on Epic Kids Online. Yet he himself